as an archipelago. The Philippine Islands needs an infrastructure project that will connect its people across the country. The Build Better More Infrastructure Agenda of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. was an adaptation of the previous administration's Build 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 program. These infrastructure initiatives were the Philippines government's centerpiece program to usher the Philippines into its golden age of infrastructure. To date, numerous completed infrastructure projects, such as expanded highways, railways, airports, bridges, and road networks, have reduced the distance between regions, shortened road trips, and improved the overall travel experience for commuters, business travelers, and local tourists' access to previously far-flung places. In the future, it will enhance further as hundreds of infrastructure projects are in progress or are planned to be constructed for the preparation of making the country an advanced economy by 2040. Here are the top 10 biggest projects in the Philippines, which are under construction and will be completed by 2025 onwards. The Bata-an Cavite Interlink Bridge is a 32-kilometer and 150-meters four-lane cable-stayed bridge. It will stretch 17 kilometers between Cavite and Corregidor Island, and more than 4 kilometers between Bata-an and Corregidor Island. The project will involve the construction of two cable-stayed navigation bridges, the North Channel Bridge, with a main span of 400 meters. And the South Channel Bridge with a 900-meter main span, standing at a water depth of approximately 50 meters. It will connect Bataan in the north, and Cavite in the south, the two adjacent provinces of Metro Manila. This cable-stayed bridge has sped up travel from 5 hours down to just 30 minutes between Bataan and Cavite. The government's commitment to fast-track its implementation, and manifested that civil work will be started immediately and would be completed under the Marcos government, as it ends in 2028. The new Manila International Airport is an under-construction airport city in Bulacan that will serve as the main aviation gateway in the Philippines. The 2,500 hectares of airport will relieve the air traffic operations at the existing and overly congested Ninoy Aquino International Airport. The $15 billion projects will be developed by a local firm, San Miguel Corporation, which was granted by the Philippines government a 50-year franchise that involves the construction, operation, and maintenance of the airport. The development includes a passenger terminal building with airside and landside facilities, an airport toll road, and four runways. The gateway has a design capacity of 100 million passengers a year but can be expanded to 200 million, and is targeted to accommodate 240 aircraft movements per hour, making New Manila International Airport the biggest airport in Southeast Asia and the second biggest airport in the world. Under this massive program, approximately 1,700 hectares of new land will be developed for the airport. The land development project is set to be designed according to the highest technical and environmental standards to withstand potential large earthquakes, local typhoons, and future sea level rise. This capital project is expected to be completed by the end of 2024. PNR North-South Commuter Rail Project, Philippines. PNR North-South Commuter Railway is envisioned as a 163-kilometer suburban railway network, connecting the regional business districts in Clark and New Clark City in the north, passing through central Manila to Calamba City in Laguna Province, south of the capital. The NSCR corridor will provide interchange with all of the existing Metro Manila rail lines, through the connection of MRT Line 3 and MRT Line 9 of the Metro Manila subway. A notable feature of NSCR will be the first airport rail shuttle in the Philippines. This airport express service will reduce the journey time between Clark International Airport in Pampanga and Makati City, the main business district in the capital, to less than an hour, compared to at least 2 hours by car at present. NSCR's technical parameters envisage a maximum operating speed of 120 km per hour for the commuter trains, and 160 km per hour for the airport express and semi-fast services trains. NSCR Phase 1 projects, contract package 1 Solis to Bocaui, is 31.04% complete. And contract package 2 Balagtas to Malolos, is 58.8% complete. With the columns for contract package 2 already 75.5% complete. Overall, NSCR Phase 1 is 51% complete, while NSCR Phase 2 is 32% overall progress rate as of September 2021. On the other hand, the South Commuter Railway Project or NSCR Phase 3, pre-construction activities begin by the latter part of 2022, and by February 2023, will begin the full-scale construction works. Once fully operational, the NSCR corridor is expected to carry up to 800,000 passengers per day. The Metro Manila Subway Project is one of the first two underground railway system projects in the Philippines, which aims to provide mass transportation in the National Capital Region. The first phase of the 33-kilometer subway connecting the north and south of Metro Manila will run from Mindanao Avenue in Valenzuela City to the FTI compound in Taguig City, with a spur connecting to the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. On October 3, two additional stations in Ortigas and Shaw Boulevard broke ground, witnessed by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., Japanese Ambassador Koshikawa Kazuhiko, and Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista. Groundworks started in the first quarter of this year, while the tunneling works of the partial operability section started last June 2022. All 17 stations will be fully operational by 2028, with a design capacity of 1.5 million passengers per day. The Makati Intra-City Subway is a 10-kilometer under-construction underground rapid transit line located in Makati City that will link establishments across the city's business district. The Makati Subway Project, the first of its kind in the country, will be built at no cost to the city through a public-private partnership agreement between Makati City and Philippine Infradev Holdings Incorporated. It will operate 18 hours a day, serving some 700,000 passengers daily. The project has been set for completion by 2025. The Metro Rail Transit 7 or MRT Line 7, which is now at 60% overall completion rate, will support essential operations by end of 2023. These rail and road projects have three major components: a 22.8-kilometer mass rail transit system starting from North Avenue Common Station to San Jose del Monte Bulacan, a world-class intermodal transportation terminal that will serve as a transportation hub catering to other types of public transportation, and a 19-kilometer highway from San Jose del Monte to Bocaui Bulacan. The line will be operated with 108 rail cars in a 3-car configuration or 36 train sets, and will be able to carry 28,000 to 36,000 passengers in an hour per direction. It can accommodate 300,000 passengers daily in its first year of operation, and up to 850,000 passengers once it will be fully operational. The LRT Line 1 Cavite Extension. The construction of the first phase of the 64 billion pesos light rail transit Line 1 Cavite Extension is now 73% complete, in a statement from LRMC, the private sector operator of LRT Line 1. Phase 1 of the 11.7-kilometer LRT 1 Cavite extension project, which covers a total of 5 stations, will add the existing 20.7-kilometer of metro lines serving the southern part of Metro Manila. Once completed, the 11.7 kilometers extension will reduce travel time between Baclaran and Bacoor Cavite to 25 minutes, from 1 hour and 10 minutes. In addition, it will also increase LRT Line 1 capacity from 500,000 to 800,000 passengers daily. The biggest under-construction bridge project in Mindanao is the Pandul Bay Bridge. The bridge will connect Tangub City in Misamis Occidental and Tubod in Lanao del Norte via a 3-kilometer and 170-meter two-lane bridge. The megastructure project that began back in February 2020 is now more than 60% complete. The structure features a main bridge that measures 320 meters in length and approach bridges and roads that measure more than 1.9 kilometers in total. It has a total project budget of 7.3 billion pesos, courtesy of a loan between the Philippines and the Korean Export-Import Bank. Bridging the geographical gap between Tubod and Tangub City and Ozamas City area, Pandul Bay Bridge will reduce travel time between Lanao del Norte and Misamis Occidental from 2 hours to just 7 minutes. The construction blitz started following the full completion of all 54 board piling works to allow the start of construction of the 36 abutments and pier column, 32 copings, and commence on both ends at Tubod and Tangub City in the incremental launching method for the superstructure. While construction by about 336 manpower takes place round the clock to complete the project by December 2023. The Common Station of Manila, or dubbed as Unified Grand Central Station, is a state-of-the-art, rapid transit terminal and transportation hub along EDSA, located between SM City North and the Ayala Mall Trinoma. This unified station will feature a 13,700 square meters concourse area, which will seamlessly connect the rail lines of LRT Line 1, MRT Line 3, MRT Line 7, and MRT Line 9 of Metro Manila Subway. Aside from the rail lines, this common station will also connect to the EDSA bus carousel through the EDSA busway and to the transportation hub terminals in the area. Once operational, the common station is expected to serve approximately 500,000 passengers per day and can serve up to 1.5 million passengers daily once the MRT Line 7 and MRT Line 9 will be fully operational. One Ayala Grand Terminal is an intermodal transport hub that will meld Makati City's mass transportation modes into a single, unified system. It is part of a 390,000 square meter transit-oriented development located on Ayala Avenue corner EDSA. This huge mixed transport-oriented development will feature a 20,000 square meter transportation hub terminal serving EDSA and Makati Central Business District with connections to the MRT Line 3 and EDSA busway. It will also feature safe, covered, and well-maintained elevated walkways, allowing commuters to get to their respective rides and pedestrians to reach nearby destinations. The Unified Grand Central Stations and One Ayala are the nearly completed intermodal transport hub of Metro Manila that will complement the operation of the biggest and the first integrated and multimodal terminal of the country, the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange or PITX.